Welcome friends to our channel Stay Focused. So in the series of software engineering, today we are going to see another concept of software testing, that is debugging. So let's start what debugging is. So let me tell you simply what is debugging. So after the software is developed, we test the software that it works correctly or not. So during the testing of the software, after testing we find out if there are any errors in the software or if there are any bugs. Then we identify the bugs to repair that bugs. So from starting to the identification of bug by the process of testing, we just simply test the software. But after identifying the identifying any bugs or error, we have to repair that bugs or errors. So the reparation of that bug is known as our debugging. So as you can see the definition, debugging is the activity performed by the developer to fix the bug found in the system. So debugging activity is performed by the developer or the programmer. But in the case of testing is performed by the software tester. Please keep this in mind. Debugging is the activity performed by the developer to fix the bug found in the system. So what is bug? Bug is a type of error, or we can say that cause it to produce any incorrect or unexpected result of the software. So after a failure has been detected, it is necessary to first identify the program statement that are in error and are responsible for the failure, and the error can then be fixed. As I've already told you, we have to first test the software and identify if there are any bugs or errors, then we can fix that bug. So debugging process is not a testing process, but it is the result of testing. I think you can understand this. After the testing is done, according to the test result, we have to debug if there is any error in the software. So there are basically three type of debugging approaches that are brute force method, backtracking, and cause elimination method. So what is brute force method? Brute force is a common method used in every debugging process. So brute force is commonly used and least efficient method for separating or eliminating the cause of software errors. So this is the most common method of debugging. So what we done in this approach, we just simply replace the print statements, or we can add some print statement to check whether the code is working fine, or if there are any errors in the code. As you can see, if there is any condition or any loop in your code, so we can simply provide a print statement to check whether the loop or condition is working fine or not. So in this approach, print statements are inserted throughout the program to print the intermediate value with the hope that some of the printed value will help to identify the error. So then what is backtracking method? So as the name suggests, backtracking, we have to trace the error backwardly. Okay, after the testing is done, we have to trace the bugs from the backward of the source code. So backtracking is successfully used in small programs. Okay. In this approach, beginning from the statement at which an error symptoms has been observed, the source code is traced backwards until the error is discovered. Okay. After the testing, if there are any errors or bugs in the software, we have to trace backwardly of the source code until the error is discovered. So if there is any complex code or lengthy code, it will be costlier for us to apply the backtracking method, because in complex programs or complex source of codes, for tracing the error backwardly is more time consuming and costly. And the last method is cause elimination method. So let's see the definition first. In this approach, once a failure is observed, the symptoms of the failure are noted. Okay. After performing the testing operation, if there are any failure observed or if there is any bugs or error observed, the symptoms of that error is noted, and based on the symptoms, based on the symptoms, we apply some recovery method, or we can say according to the symptoms, we apply some error elimination method. So this is cause elimination method. So this is all about our debugging approaches of debugging. So let's see what is debugging and testing, or we can say the difference between debugging and testing. So what is testing? The purpose of testing is to find bugs and errors, and the purpose of debugging is to correct those bugs and errors. As I already told you, first we have to perform the testing operation, then after testing operation is performed, we identify if there are any errors or not, then we debug that error. And testing is done by the software tester, and while the debugging is done by programmer or the developer. Okay, testing is automated, or it may be manually, but debugging is compulsory manual. It cannot be automated, and testing can be done without any design knowledge. Okay, so to test a software, the tester does not need any design knowledge. The tester only have to know the inputs to give the given the software to test the software. But in debugging, without proper design knowledge, a developer programmer cannot debug a bug. Okay, so this is all about debugging in software testing. So thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please like and subscribe our channel and share with your friends. And if there are any doubts, you can comment below. So thank you.